So the Sustainable Finance Foundation course, it's our flagship course. We do it once a year. And what we're trying to do is to bring together the best and brightest future leaders who are going to shape the future of sustainable finance around the world. And so it's for people that want to know more about sustainable finance, people that want to have a firm foundation in this area so they can go forward and influence and shape these different markets, these different policy areas. And of course, the topics themselves will change over time. This space is evolving very, very quickly. So we emphasize the need to understand really the key principles and foundations of this area so they can apply those to different contexts.
It's beyond important to know about sustainable finance, and not just if you're a finance professional. There's a large amount of ignorance, illiteracy about finance in other critical parts of our economy and society. There's a lot of mistrust. There is a need to translate, to interpret, to build confidence that languages can be connected, combined, properly understood. What are the motivations behind an investor's investment? Why do they have their risk and return obsession stand in the way of things that you think are important they ought to be investing in? How do you communicate your desire for where you want the money to go with theirs and their professional standards, the ways in which they are rewarded and incentivized? This is a space which requires constant connecting and reconnecting, explaining and sometimes just spending time together so that relationships can be built of trust and understanding, which make it more likely that we will channel the capital that we have, and we don't lack capital in the world, towards the solutions to these big systemic environment and development risks, of which climate change is the most significant, driving many other risks.
So what we're trying to do with the course is to take each participant through a bit of a journey. So the first day is focused on key principles of sustainable finance. The second day is focused on how do we get capital to flow into solutions to climate change, to the big environmental challenges we're facing, particularly on biodiversity and nature, to these questions of, you know, what are the conditions that need to hold for investment to flow at scale to solve these problems. The third day is focused on how we green the financial system. How do financial institutions measure risk? How do they manage it? The fourth day is about applying those concepts to company strategy and to, we have this tradition at Oxford of debating, and we bring people to debate at the Oxford Union, one of the oldest debating societies in the world. And then we're also throughout the course and, you know, on the fifth day trying to bring this all together, particularly around coursework and the Capstone project. So each student has a Capstone project, essentially a project over 6 to 9 months that they do after the course. Their support after the course finishes, from us, from their peer group. And these projects can vary enormously from writing a book through to developing a new corporate strategy to deal with climate change, through to financing different projects, to campaigns. So a whole range of different projects that people undertake. And one of the attractions of that is that people can apply what they've learned, but also bring back what they've learned in a tangible form to the organisation that they're based in.
I think the Oxford Sustainable Finance Foundation course is very important as a good grounding in understanding how the capital markets, the debt markets, the equity markets operate and how that interacts with climate change and resilience and adaptation objectives from a policy perspective.
A course such as this is a brilliant contribution to the effort that we need to undertake pretty much everywhere in the world, but maybe particularly in the financial centres of the world, so that we can make capital flow fit the scale of the climate problem that we've got.